Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm not too sure what's going to come out of this interview with this Chinese communist soldier, but let's find out. What's your name?
My name Hong Yi.
Where are you from?
Me from Harbin, Montreal.
That's your home?
Yeah, my home.
Well, how long have you been in the Chinese army?
I'm in the army for 5 years.
You've been a private all that time?
Private all the time.
Are you a communist?
Me, good communist, yes.
Well, why?
Reason for communists is because they give me lots of promise. They give me safety for my family.
Who promises you all this?
Oh, big man.
Oh, big man. Huh?
Yeah, big man.
Well, how about the fact that don't you realize that you're the victim of Chinese propaganda?
Me victim?
Communist propaganda.
Me victim? No. You're a victim.
Oh, I'm a victim.
Yeah, you're a victim.
Well, in other words, I don't know the truth.
You don't know the truth. Me know everything. They tell us everything.
Look, we're not getting anywhere, but I want to ask you this one question. Why do you stupidly stay in your foxholes and trenches when you can see the American infantry coming?
To save world from American capitalist Wall Street.
Have you ever been on Wall Street?
Me don't want to go Wall Street.
Why don't you?
Not safe.
Not safe. Well, who's going to hurt you?
Oh, everybody come get my money away. Family not safe.
Oh, I see. Well, is that the only reason you won't stay in your foxhole? Or that you do stay in your foxhole?
No. Commissar tell us to stay there.
Who's he?
He a big man.
Well, he's a big man. What is he, in your battalion?
No, he big man.
Oh, I see. Now, he's going to make you stay in your foxhole. Suppose you don't stay in your foxhole. What's going to happen to you?
Me no stay in. He chop my neck off.
Well, you finally made a little sense there. Ladies and gentlemen, that last aspect is real motivation, that off of the neck proposition. What kind of uniform is that? That's a winter uniform, I guess.
Yeah.
What's it made of?
Good cotton padding. Very good uniform, warm. All communists got good uniform.
Oh, I see. Is that made in China?
Yeah, made in Manchuria.
Oh, Manchuria. I see. Where does your rifle come from and your bullets? Where do they come from?
Oh, good friend, Soviet Russia give us equipment.
Oh, they're your great ally, is that right?
Yeah, good friend.
I see. Do the Russians give you plenty of supplies and equipment?
Yeah, they give us plenty supplies.
Why?
Oh, to fight American warmongers.
Oh, I see, we're warmongers again. Look, when you go into a fight, when you go into battle, what do you carry besides your rifle?
Rice bag and fish to eat.
Rice bag and fish?
Yeah.
Don't you carry any medical supplies or anything when you go into attack?
Don't need them.
Oh, you don't need them?
No.
I see. Well, you're just a private anyway. You wouldn't know, would you?
I don't know.
Now, look. So when you do go into battle, and when you are in there fighting, and you run out of food and ammunition, how are you resupplied? Do people bring it up to you?
My friend died there, my friend died here. They don't have use. Me take them.
Oh, I see. You take them. You rob the dead on the field of battle. Is that right?
They don't have use. Me take them.
Well, there you are, ladies and gentlemen. The commie logic goes on and on. Makes no reason, makes no sense. But in any event, today and now, I want to introduce to you the star of our communist soldier plot, if you will, Sergeant Kim, United States Army. Sergeant, thanks a lot for being with us.
It's been a pleasure to be able to do my part, sir.
You don't know how much we appreciate your taking such a poor part, but I must say convincing. Incidentally, Sergeant, Where is your hometown?
My hometown is in Honolulu, Hawaii.
Well, thanks again for being with us, and I hope that you don't have to take this kind of part anymore.
Thank you, sir.
Well, that's about it for today, ladies and gentlemen. I wish you would drop in on us next week when we tell you the story about the 34th Division in Europe. We're also going to tell you about the United States Family of Medals for Heroism and a great number of many interesting sidelights on the Congressional Medal of Honor. So until we meet again, ladies and gentlemen, this is Colonel Quinn speaking for the combat infantrymen who ask you to look twice at the man who wears the blue badge. It's the mark of a man.
The Big Picture is a weekly television report to the nation on the activities of the Army at home and overseas. Produced by the Signal Corps Pictorial Center. Presented by the U.S. Army in cooperation with this station. You can be an important part of the Big Picture. You can proudly serve with the best equipped, the best trained, the best fighting team in the world today, the United States Army.